First question is, which of the following statements is wrong? Option A, naked seeds are seen in gymnosperms. Option B, endospores are produced by pteridophyta. Option C, basidiocarpus fruiting body of fungus. And option D, capsule is the sporophyte or bryophyta. The answer to this question is quite straightforward, which is option B, because endospores are not produced by pteridophyta. Our next question is, why is viviparity an undesirable character for annual crop plants? Option A, it reduces the vigor of the plant. Option B, the seeds cannot be stored in the normal conditions for the next season. Option C, the seeds exhibit long dormancy. And option D, it adversely affects the fertility of the plant. However, it has been observed that the vigor of the plant is not largely affected due to viviparity. Also, the seeds do not exhibit dormancy for a long period of time, and the fertility of the plant also stays unaffected in spite of viviparity. But the problem with viviparity is that the seeds cannot be stored under normal conditions for the next season. Special conditions are demanded, which increase the cost and reduce the productivity, as a result of which this makes viviparity an undesirable character. Our next question is, a mature male gametophyte is formed from pollen mother cell by option A, 1 meiotic division, option B, 2 meiotic divisions, option C, 1 meiotic and 2 mitotic divisions, and option D, 3 meiotic divisions. So here the correct answer is option C, which is 2 meiotic divisions and 1 mitotic divisions, wherein during the meiotic divisions the number of chromosomes doesn't change, while in mitotic divisions the number of chromosomes becomes half. Our next question is, the arrangement of nuclei in a normal embryo sac in the dicot plants is option A, 2 plus 4 plus 2, option B, 3 plus 2 plus 3, option C, 2 plus 3 plus 3, and option D, 3 plus 3 plus 2. If we can recall the structure of the embryo sac, then we show three antipodals near the chalazal end, polar nuclei or the secondary nucleus in the center, and an egg surrounded by two synergids near the micropylar end. Thus, the arrangement of nuclei can be described as 3 plus 2 plus 3. Also, we can recall that the embryo sac is a 7 cell, 8 nucleate structure. Our next question is, Nucella polyembryonia is reported in species of option A, Citrus, option B, Gossypium, option C, Triticum, and option D, Brassica. The Nucella polyembryonia is a case wherein Nucella cells directly get converted into polyembryo, which is a precursor to the embryo. And this condition is observed in species of Citrus. So the answer to this question is option A. Our next question is, male gametes in angiosperms are formed by the division of option A, generative cell, option B, vegetative cell, option C, microspore mother cell, and option D, microspore. So the answer to this question, as the name can suggest, is the generative cell, which generates two male gametes, which are seen in the pollen tube of the male gametophyte. The vegetative cell is the tube cell. The answer to this question is option A, which is the generative cell. Our next question is, what would be the number of chromosomes of the aleurone cells of a plant with 42 chromosomes in its root tip cells? Option A, 42, option B, 63, option C, 84, and option D, 21. The answer to this question is option B, which is 63. The root tip cells of a plant are known to have 42 chromosomes in this case, and we also know that the root tip cells are diploid, so the number of chromosomes becomes 21. Accordingly, we know that aleurone cells are triploid, and so the number of chromosomes in this case is 3 into 21, which is 63, which is option B. So the answer is 63. Our next question is, an organic substance that can withstand environmental extremes and cannot be degraded by any enzyme is option A, sporopollenin, option B, lignin, option C, cellulose, and option D, cuticle. The answer to this question is option C, which is cellulose. And this property of cellulose makes it highly useful. Some of the common use of cellulose includes paper making and furniture. Our next question is, the mode of asexual reproduction in bacteria are option A, formation of gametes, option B, endospore formation, option C, conjugation, and option D, zoospore formation. The answer to this question is option B, which is endospore formations, which are spores formed inside the structure or the organism. Option A, which is formation of gametes, is exhibited in case of higher organisms like humans and plants, while option D, which is zoospore formation, is the mode of asexual reproduction seen in algae. Our next question is, which of the following represents the edible part of the fruit of lychee? Option A, pericarp. Option B, mesocarp. Option C, the juicy aril. And option D, the endocarp. Although generally the mesocarp is the part which is edible, like in case of fruits like the mango, however in case of lychee, the juicy aril is the edible part, and thus the answer to this question is option C, which is juicy aril. Our next question is, which one of the following represents an ovule where the embryo sac becomes horseshoe shaped and the funiculus and micropyle are close to each other? The options are A, Circinotropus, B, Anthrotropus, C, Amphitropus, and D, Atropus. The answer to this question is option C, which is Amphitropus, and needs to be remembered. Our next question is, in which one pair both the plants can be vegetatively propagated by leaf pieces? Option A, Bryophyllum and Calanchae. Option B, Chrysanthemum and Agave. Option C, Agave and Calanchae. And option D, Asparagus and Bryophyllum. The answer to this question is option A, which is Bryophyllum and Calanchae, and it is very important that we remember these names. Our next question is, both autogamy and geotonogamy are prevented in option A, cucumber, option B, castor, option C, maize, and option D, papaya. The answer to this question is option D, wherein both autogamy and geotonogamy are prevented. Autogamy is the case wherein transfer of pollen grains from the anther to stamen takes place from the flower, which is present on the same plant, also in the same flower. While in case of geotonogamy, transfer takes place from the anther to stamen of different flowers but belonging on the same plant. Our next question is, if meiosis occurs inside pollen grain and egg nuclei, it will be option A, zygotic meiosis, option B, gametic meiosis, option C, sporic meiosis, and option D, none of the above. The answer to this question is option B, which is gametic meiosis, because the pollen grain and the egg nuclei are responsible for the formation of the male and female gametophytes.
Question number 15. Formation of fruits without fertilization is known as, or ovary no fertilization gives you fruit, that is called as parthenocarpy. When seedless fruit, noble varieties, are produced by removal of pollination, the process is called as parthenocarpy. So option A is the correct answer. Question number 16. Presence of many embryos, polyembryony, is characteristic feature of A, citrus, B, mango, C, banana, D, none of these. So as we know that in angiosperm, citrus have two or more than two embryos in one seed, it is called as polyembryony. So option A is the correct answer.
Our next question is, the mature anther wall comprises an epidermis followed by a layer of radially elongated cells with fibrous bands of callose called endothecium, whose function is option A, nutrition, option B, protection, option C, mechanical, and option D, dehiscence. The correct answer to this question is option D, which is dehiscence, as it helps in drying. Our next question is, mature ovules are classified based on the funiculus. If microbial comes to lie close to the funiculus, the ovule is termed as option A, orthotropous, option B, anatropous, option C, amphitropous, and option D, camphylotropous. The answer to this question is option B, which is anatropous, because in case of an anatropous ovule, the microbial comes close to the funiculus. Our next question is, when seeds develop without meiosis and syngamy, the phenomenon is option A, parthenogenesis, option B, parthenocarpy, option C, egg gametospermy, option D, apogamy. The correct answer to this question is option D, which is apogamy. Parthenocarpy is the condition wherein no seeds are generated, which is exhibited in parthenocarpic fruits like banana. However, in apogamy, seeds are developed, but they are developed without meiosis and syngamy. Our next question is, perisperm in angiospermic seed is developed from option A, nucellus, option B, endosperm, option C, integuments, and option D, antipodal cells. The correct answer to this question is option A, which is nucellus, as the perisperm develops from the nucellus in an angiospermic seed. A normal plant suddenly started reproducing parthenogenetically. The number of chromosomes of the second generation as compared to the parent plant will be option A, double, option B, half, option C, 1/4, and option D, the same. Parthenocarpy is a phenomenon wherein seeds are not produced, and this is exhibited by parthenocarpic fruits like banana, wherein there are no seeds. So the correct answer to this question is option D, because the number of chromosomes remains same in parthenocarpic conditions, because the chromosomes do not combine, or the male and female gametes are not known to combine, as a result of which the chromosomes remain same in number.